And you are the branches leaving me, and you will never die.
Fifth Sunday of Easter, year B, bearing fruit. The liturgy today stresses on the importance of bearing fruit. Jesus compares us to branches on the vine. He calls himself the vine, and he calls us the branches. As part of the vine, we are truly alive and we produce good fruits. We do good things. But when we become separated from Jesus, we begin to wither and can't really do anything good at all. And if we go on too long like this, we will die. But if we turn back to Jesus in time and become attached again to him, and allow his love to flow through us as sap flows through the vine and its branches, then we will live and produce the beautiful fruit of good works and praise unto God's name. The gospel goes on to speak about bearing fruit. If the branches are united to the vine, the branches will bear fruit, much fruit. If the branches are not united to the vine, the branches will wither and die, and there will be no fruit. In our first reading from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 9, verse 26 to 31, Barnabas also bears fruit and shows a Christian love that is not just in words or mere talks, but something real and active. When the church in Jerusalem doubted the genuineness of Paul's conversion, and Barnabas introduced Paul to them, assuring them of his conversion. Some years later, in the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 11, verse 25 to 26, Barnabas will again introduce Paul to the church, this time in Antioch, from where Paul would begin his preaching journeys. We all know what a difference Paul made to the church, and it was Barnabas who prepared the way for him. So what a difference it makes to the whole church when we bear fruit and love with a Christian love that is real and active and not just words or mere talk. Jesus is the center of our lives, holding us together. Jesus asks us to make our home in him so that we can bear fruit. Are we bearing fruit for the kingdom of God? Is our Christian love real and active, or just words and mere talks? God calls us to make his message real in the world. He calls us to be witnesses of the resurrection. He calls us to bring love to the world. He is not calling us just to be in his presence. He is calling us to transform the world with his presence. Husbands and wives, parents and children, neighbors and friends, priests and laity, we are all called to live the life that matters, so completely that others are attracted to that life. The life of Christ is like a magnet. When people experience the life in others, they want it for themselves. It's like, you know, nectar that attracts honey. These people, those who turn to God, are to bear fruit. They are the fruit we have to bring. Our union with God will draw many people to him. Then we are bearing fruits. They are the fruits we have been called to bear. We must bear these fruits in our homes, in our schools, in our small Christian communities, and in whatever we do. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I am the vine, and my Father is